Right, let's continue to unpack this as we speak to former Nigerian footballer and Swallows goalkeeper Greg Etafia, who joins me now via our video link. Greg, a very good morning to you. Thank you so much for making time. It's a wonderful day today as the start of Afcon. Let's speak about your native Nigeria, though. They not too happy, Odion Ighalo not there, as well as Emmanuel Dennis. But, of course, they still have a job to do.
Yeah, good morning. I mean, they still have a job to do because Nigeria, you know, a lot of expectations from Nigerian supporters because it has been long, you know, for Nigeria haven't won the Afcon. You know, remember the last time we won it in South Africa, 2013. So they're looking forward for this generation to win this one. And nevertheless, Ighalo is not there, Emmanuel Dennis is not there, Osimhen is not there. You know, a lot of, I mean, the target men in terms of the strikers are not there, but at least Nigeria still have a lot of quality to able to come out of this tournament.
Quality indeed, but let's talk about those exclusions. And I mean, it's too late now to be pointing fingers at who should have done what and when it should have been done. But Ighalo, a key personnel missing from the front line of the attack. I mean, the last AFCON, he was the top scorer. That goes to show that he really will be a key figure or would have been a key figure for the Nigerians.
Yeah, definitely. You know, Odion Ighalo is one player Nigerian really, you know, expect to go to this tournament and do very well. You know, as you earlier alluded to, you know, in 2019, he was the top scorer for Nigeria. You know, we are just unfortunately, we went out through that Mahrez free kick against Algeria. But this tournament, you know, because initially he retired, you know, and they have to call him back, you know, to come and help, you know, for two qualifiers. So the tournament, everyone expects him to go. But, you know, before he signed in this club in Al-Shabaab in Saudi there, I think he has a clause that he's not going to, you know, honor international, you know, football. So that's what, you know, the main issue was, you know. And, you know, for him to be on the 40-man list and after they make the 28-man list to go to the tournament, all of a sudden now the team don't, the club don't want to release him. And Nigeria, you know, Nigeria always, you know, they have that, you know, intention in terms of if you don't want to come, there's other players to replace you. So they've already, you know, have someone to replace him. But CAF, there's a rule that says that if you're not injured or if something not serious, you cannot just replace the person. So now it's unfortunate Nigeria has to go with 27 players. Mm-hmm. And, you know, with that 27 players, I think they're going to do well, you know, because there's a lot of quality in that team.
I mean, before we talk about Nigeria's fixtures, they're in a very difficult group. But let's talk just about, you know, the releasing of players and how AFCON is seen globally. It's kind of seen as a second-string tournament. If you look at what happens in the Euros, the entire European calendar comes to a stop. Of course, AFCON carries a lot of players in Europe as well, key players at that. I mean, the likes of Mo Salah, and I can just go on. But do you feel like it is still not really taken as a serious tournament, as serious as it should be?
Yeah, we, you know, this issue has been going on for a long time, you know, and it's time for CAF and FIFA, you know, need to address this issue because there's a lot of Nigerian players in Europe that, you know, add value to their club, you know. So, but, you know, this tournament, everyone know, even the European club, they know that, you know, every two years, there's a tournament which is the biggest showpiece in Africa that the players need to present their country. And it's an honor for any player, no matter which country you represent, it's an honor for you to present your country. This is our World Cup. This is one big, apart from the Champions League, this is the biggest tournament in Africa. And every player dream is for him to play the tournament. So I just think sometimes, you know, where this issue normally comes from is only in the English league, that's the EPL. That's where, you know, some of the teams, you know, when they are struggling to escape relegation, if you see, most of the problems don't come with the top teams, in the likes of Liverpool, Manchester, you know, Arsenal. They don't have this problem because, you know, they always in the top four and they're always in a good position. So most of the teams that have this problem are the teams that are struggling on the bottom. So, yeah, I think they need to address this issue because, I mean, these are biggest tournaments. It should be respected. And I think, you know, when the Euros were playing, it was playing over, across over 12 countries and it was in the pandemic. And there was no issue about that. But this is our biggest tournament. We need our biggest players in the tournament. And I think every player that, apart from injury, I think they should be representing their country in this tournament.
The Super Eagles, Greg, have a humdinger as an opening match against Egypt on Tuesday, but they'll also be taking on Sudan as well as Guinea-Bissau in their group. How do you see the group panning out, and how should they approach that game against the Egyptians?
Yeah, I think it's going to be a very difficult game because, you know, in a tournament like this, first game is always important, you know, and, you know, with the problem in Egyptian camp in terms of the COVID-19 situation with their first choice goalkeeper and their goalkeeper trainer and some of the players, I think, you know, yeah, it's an advantage for Nigeria to, you know, to really, you know, do well against them. Mo Salah is going to be a key player for Egypt, but yeah, I mean, he's not playing alone. You know, and I think Nigeria needs to work around other players to get the supply against Mo Salah. So I just think with the quality we have in terms of our defense and the midfield, I think we can contain them. But it's going to be a very difficult game because in every tournament, the first game is very important. And the Nigerians, which we like, you know, to at least get 3 points, if not 3 points, 1 point, and the same thing with the Egyptians. Because Egyptians now in their football, I mean, this one tournament, they need to win because with their new FA president saying that, you know, this tournament, they're going there to win it. And the same thing with Nigeria, you know. So I just think it's going to be a big game for everyone.
Talk to me about some of your favorites. Of course, Nigeria will be one of them. But who do you think will have a very good run in the tournament as well?
You know, depends on where your passage is. You know, because you have a lot of top contenders in this tournament. You know, the likes of Senegal, you know, which I think for me personally, they have a lot of depth. Because in this tournament, depth is going to take you through. You know, because if you have a lot of depth in terms of apart from your personal level, you know, the players that come from the substitute are very important. And you know, with CAF allowing 5 substitutes, it's very important. You know. The substitutes add value, and well, as time goes on in the tournament, you know, there's going to be injuries, you know. So I think the likes of Senegal, the likes of Algeria, the likes of Nigeria, you know, Egypt is there, you know, and, you know, host country Cameroon, and Eto being the president, and I think it's going to be a big impact for Cameroon. I mean, I think Cameroon will try to show themselves, and this is the second time, you know, in the opening ceremony. The last time was 1998, Cameroon played against Burkina Faso, you know, the first game, and Cameroon won 1-0. I think this one again is going to be a good one. I think Cameroon is among the top favorites.
Greg Etafia, thank you so much for your time. That is the former Nigerian shot stopper as well as PSL shot stopper, played for various clubs in South Africa as well.